Thank you for watching this video from KingswaySoft. Today, I will be introducing the SSIS Integration Toolkit for Oracle CRM On Demand. This toolkit is a high-performance data integration solution that works for Oracle CRM On Demand and Microsoft SQL Server Integration Services. In today's demo, we will show you our software running in SQL Server 2012. If you're using a different SQL Server version, the interface might be slightly different. To get started, let's create a simple SSIS project. This tutorial will assume that you have the SSIS bits already installed, otherwise you will not see the SSIS project type here. In the Business Intelligence template, select the Integration Services project and give your project a name. Press OK to create the solution. As you can see from the interface, SSIS is a platform that can be used to implement data migration and integration solutions using drag and drop features. To begin the SSIS implementation using our toolkit, we will create a connection to the Oracle CRM On Demand server. To do so, right-click in the Connection Manager area and select New Connection. Then we will choose CRM On Demand from the list and select Add. The web service URL allows you to specify the URL of your web service. You can obtain this information from your sign-in URL. Next, we can see the authentication section. The authentication mode supported by our connection manager is the login credentials in the SOAP security header. You would enter in the user credentials to authenticate with the Oracle CRM On Demand server. There is a timeout setting where you can specify server call timeout value. The default is 120 seconds. After we enter in the login credentials, we can test the connection to see that a successful connection has been made with the Oracle CRM On Demand server. There is also support for proxy server connection settings, which you can enter if you're behind a proxy server. There is an option to retry on intermittent errors. If this option is checked, it will attempt to recover from potential intermittent outages or disruption of service so that the integration does not have to be stopped due to temporary networking issues. We have designed this option so that it should only retry when it is deemed to be safe to do so. The next step is to use the data flow components offered by the SSIS Integration Toolkit for Oracle CRM On Demand. To see the components, make sure you're in the data flow view. If you do not see these components, click the SSIS Toolbox button here. The source component is used to read data from the CRM On Demand server, while the destination component is used to write data to CRM On Demand. If you are using SSIS 2012 or later, you will automatically see these data flow components. If you are using SSIS 2008R2 or earlier, you would need to manually add these components to the SSIS data flow toolbox. Let's go to SSIS 2008. Make sure you're in the data flow view or else you will not see the items. Then, right-click on the toolbox and select Choose Items. Click the SSIS data flow items tab and select the Oracle CRM On Demand destination and source component. Once again, make sure you're in the data flow view to see these components in the toolbox. Let's go back to SSIS 2012. To use the source component, we can simply drag this component to the design surface of the data flow. Double-click the component and select the connection manager. Notice that the default batch size is 100. This means that the component will retrieve 100 records per service call from the Oracle CRM On Demand server. This is also the maximum amount allowed by the server. The source WSDL dropdown lists all the available WSDL files. You can modify or add additional WSDL files by placing it in the default folder path located on the C drive under Program Files, KingswaySoft, SSIS Integration Toolkit for Oracle CRM On Demand, Schemas. Any changes will be reflected within the dropdown. You would specify the object you would like to read from, listed in the source object. Let's select the account object. The child object is optional, This dropdown will list all the objects that belong to the source object specified. In this demo, we will select the note object to read from. Our software has sophisticated support for record filtering with the parent or child object. The filtering area allows for us to specify a search spec query to filter for desired records. You may perform filtering using the columns page as well. I will select a filter for the parent object so that we can retrieve all child records from one account for this demo. Let's go to the columns page to configure the fields that we would like to read from. As you can see, there are two tabs, one for the parent object and the other for the child. If no child object is specified, you will only see the parent tab page. You will also notice that there is a filter column. By default, all the fields are selected. It is best practice to only select the fields that you will need to use in the downstream pipeline components. Notice the Refresh Component button. Clicking this button will update the component to the latest CRM On Demand metadata. We'll click OK to finish the configuration of the source component. We will now drag a flat file destination component, connect the source to the destination, and configure this destination component to point to the file we would like to write to. In this demo, we will write the child object to a file, delete the child records from the CRM On Demand application, and rewrite the child records back to the server. We can now execute this task. After the records have been written to the flat file, I will go to the parent record in the CRM On Demand UI and delete all the child records so that in the next demonstration, we will write the records back to the server. Next, we'll create a new data flow task that demonstrates the destination component. We will use the text file as a source. We will configure this component by double-clicking on it. We'll drag a destination component from the toolbox onto the design surface and connect the components. In the destination component, we will select the same CRM on-demand connection manager we previously created. Our component supports three different action types: create, update, and delete. We will select the create action. The batch size will specify the number of records to send per service call. We will now select account in the WSDL file dropdown, which will detect the account object. We can write to the parent directly. The destination component also supports writing to the child object. Let's select the no child object. If we navigate over to the columns page, the destination fields listed are writable fields for the account specified. The input fields will automatically be mapped to the destination field if there is a name match. Otherwise, you may manually configure this. Take note of a special field, parent.id. This field only appears when a child object is selected. It points to the parent object ID. The child object ID should be mapped to the ID field. Now we will navigate over to the error handling page. The error handling page contains three error handling mechanisms to choose from to determine how errors should be handled when they occur. The default option Fail on Error will fail the component completely. The Redirect Rows to Error Output option will redirect the rows that have failed to the destination component's error output. In addition, an error code, error column, and Oracle error message output column can be found in the error output. It will contain either the information reported by the server or the component. The Ignore Error option will ignore the error. This option is generally not recommended as the component will remain silent for any errors that have occurred. We will now run this task. All the child records from the flat file will be copied over to the parent object in Oracle CRM On Demand. This concludes the demonstration of our SSIS Integration Toolkit for Oracle CRM On Demand. For any additional questions, please feel free to contact us. Thank you for watching this video.